Okay, folks, today is a very rare one. We're taking the show on the road, and I'm on my way to a friend's house where I'm going to cater a party. And the star of that party is going to be a whole roasted pig. So, yes, we're going to roast a pig on a spit for many, 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 many hours. And we're going to set this up. So it's very early in the morning. It's 5:30 right here. And I'm going to get there. We're going to prep the pig. We're going to put him on the spit. And then just relax and watch him cook for about 12 hours. So come on along. I hope you learned something. We're going to teach you how to put on a whole hog. It should be fun. See you in a bit. Okay, folks, so we made it here, and the host has started the fire already. And we gotta take the spit out so that we can put the pig on. So we'll be back in a few minutes. This is the guest of honor. And he's all ready, laid out. We brined him overnight in a nice little bath of brown sugar, kosher salt, bay leaves, I hope. And
a little citrus,
and we're gonna get him all dressed up and ready to go on the spit. So stay tuned. Okay, so I've gotten together all the ingredients that we're going to stuff the pig with. We've got some parsley, we've got thyme, we've got sage, and we've got some rosemary. Also some lovely cloves of garlic. And it's real simple. We're gonna just make some pierces under the skin just so that the different seasonings can stay in place. So just between the skin and the muscle, a little cut, just like that. And then stuff it with the garlic or the sage or whatever else you're gonna season it with. And then afterwards, I'm gonna get them all dressed up. I'm gonna salt them down. Even though we brined them, we still want them salted.
Yep.
And we're gonna stick them on the spit so we can. Okay, so we've finished stuffing the pig with all of the nice herbs and garlic and parsley and sage and all that stuff. I split his ribs open. And before we get ready to put him on, we're going to wrap up his hooves with some aluminum foil in the ears, the things that are gonna burn quickest, and his little snout. And this way they don't burn. And we're gonna rub them down with a little olive oil and then salt and pepper. And on the spit he goes. We'll be back.
Friday, undress it. He's chilling.
Okay, so now we've got him all lubed up. He's lubed with olive oil. And you've got to liberally salt him. You can't just put a little sprinkling on, because a lot of this is going to burn off in that heat. He's going to be sitting there in this hot bath at 250 degrees or 300 degrees, and it's just going to sear off. So you want your meat well seasoned. And Wilbur's taking to the salt, and the olive oil will rub down very well. So, and we'll just do the inside, do the outside. And pretty soon we're going to be all done in the spit. Okay, because they tend to burn and cook a lot faster than the rest of the pig. We've wrapped up his tail and his hooves, both front and back, his ears and his snout. Those will get taken off when we've got like 3 or 4 hours left to cook. So there he is, all dressed, ready to go. And now we're gonna place him on the spit and get him in the fire. Okay, so Wilbur's all on the rack, as they say, and ready to get going into the fire.
I think he's good. What do you think?
Okay, so we've got him in the rotisserie spit here. And as you can see, he's going for a nice roundabout ride. And we'll see you in a couple hours. So it's rolling.
You're just gonna edit this, right?
Yeah, I'm gonna edit whatever else.
You do outtakes?
Yep. So, it's been about 2.5 hours.
And we're gonna check on Wilbur finally and see how he's doing. There we go. And he's just a beautiful beast. Now, to ensure that he stays moist, we're gonna spritz him down. I got these little spritz bottles with some apple juice in it, and we're gonna just spray him down just like that and keep him nice and moist as he's cooking. We'll do this every couple of hours. But other than that, he looks absolutely beautiful. And we'll be back.
Okay, folks, so it's about 12:30. This lovely Wilbur has been on since about 8 this morning and is doing, as you can see, fabulous. I just threw in some more coals. I threw in some sprigs of rosemary and our lovely Miss Piggy to come hang out. It's all things Miss Piggy likes to eat, greens and radishes, and she's going to look beautiful when she's lying up there. So we'll be back. Okay, so the corn is on the grill, getting ready to be done. Inside the pig is resting. I took her off the spit. I'll show you when we open her up what it looks like, and we'll see you in a little bit. Okay, so we're getting ready to kick this pig roast off. We've got a lot of people here. It's going to be absolutely beautiful. The corn is ready. The pig is ready. And I'm going to open her up in a minute. There's the pig, there's the turkeys, the beans, and everything else we got. And pretty soon we're going to start this thing off. So we'll be back in a few minutes. Okay, so the corn's done. It's got its cilantro butter on it. And it looks beautiful.
Came back and said, we don't have kosher pork. We don't have pork.
Give him a kiss.
Met that Wilbur. We're gonna have to do it. We're gonna start with Ed. Here he is.
Sims on the snout.
Oh wow! Look at that skin. Look at that pork skin. Crispy, good skin.
Come on,
man. Now we got the
okay, I figured it's only fitting that you get to see what's left of our whole 80-pound pig.
Obviously, I had to mess up the words.
Not much, just a couple of carcass pieces and some bones. So evidently people liked it. And we went through about 80 ears of corn and a whole 7 quarts of beans. And now the band's playing, so I guess that means it's time to party. So I'll talk to you guys soon. I hope you learned something. See you soon. We're out. For now.
All you gotta do is drink. Why, well, I hear the dog is.